Jai WordPress. That's how we greet each other in the WordPress community back home. So Carol gave me a nice introduction about me, so I will jump directly to my topic. So if this title is not clear enough, let me define the problem clearly. How many people here are responsible for a meetup group, like organizing local meetups, organizing contributor day? It could be part of local meetup or local WordCamp. So one of the big problem that I face, I believe you might be able to relate it, is that many times we get contributors who only come for first time. So do you have a retention problem that people only come for first meetup, but for some reason they don't show up again? And that's the same problem we had back home. And we realized that the people who are not coming, they have their own reasons not to show up again. And one of it was confidence, as in they were not sure like they fit into the meetup group, because usually meetup group has a psychological partition. I won't say it's purposefully done. It's just that the people who come often hang out together and sort of make a group. And people who come for the first time feel they don't belong there, they are not accepted, so they need a little bit hand-holding. And then on the other side, people who are confident enough, they were like, okay, I'm sure I can contribute, but whether it's worth my time, whether it's my energy, what I'm getting in return. And we, after analyzing all these problems, we tried to remove this contributor's block in a different way. So the solution, no, it's not having free pizzas or bread. That would be a tasty solution. But we wanted to do something different. And one idea we tried that in our company, when we are managing projects or onboarding a member, we usually do buddy programming, kind of organize a sprint. We do it a little bit more seriously and in professional manner. Like, we love meetups, but they are run more casually. So we thought, how if we bring sprints to a translation group or translation meetup? And with this idea, we organized a sprint. Sorry for the wrong emoji. It was not a marathon. It was a software engineering sprint. And the reason for organizing that was, like, I found these four things unique about a translator, or in general, a sprint. That there is somebody, a senior guy, who is kind of hand-holding new person, as in helping them learn new things faster. Say, for a new contributor, learning GlotPress can be a blocker. It's like they know the language, they can do the translation, but now they have to figure out GlotPress. While it is easy to use software, but it still takes some time. Then most of the time, we organize meetup in a really, in a sense, to meet. So what is a clear goal? What is we are going to achieve in the meetup? Then, as I mentioned earlier, the meetup group often have groups, as in old contributor, old timer, who show up again and again, and new people who feel a little bit disoriented. So we try to address all this problem by organizing a sprint. And now, we were planning to do one of our meetup in more formal way, we started preparation much before the meetup. And the part of preparation that we identified the languages we want to address. So WordPress, this happened when WordPress 4.6 around the corner. And as Carol mentioned, that India has 23 official language. And I don't think any single Indian can speak all those languages. So we picked the three languages that are popular in our region that we targeted. And for these three languages, we identified the two tasks. We will translate WordPress core into these three languages. The Hindi translation was already done, so that task was already marked done. Then there was a WordPress 4.6 release video that was that needs translation for subtitles. So as Hindi translation was done, we had five tasks. Now again, as I said, like, we want to make it completely in a professional way, we found 5 people who will lead only one task. That one person should be responsible for only one task. The one of the feedback I got from the people who didn't show up again, that I contributed few string, but it took a week for somebody to approve them. So I'm not happy about that. So we set on these 5 people because all 5 of them were global translation editor for respective languages. So they have approval right. So not only they knew the WordPress, but they can accept strings immediately. And we blocked their time. We got them on board much before the meetup. And we gave them clear target, like you are only responsible for this task. So make sure you do the you help your team for this task only. So then we had RSVP, we sent this plan to the team in advance. All the meetup attendees from meetup.com received this email where we talked about how we are going to run this meetup. So the goal was set clear. There will be 5 teams, leads, purpose, task, everything was clear upfront to the meetup attendees. Then came the execution day, the actual meetup day. So we started with mentoring first, as in everybody was talked about, we explained the role to every person. We specifically asked all the GTEs to not translate a single string. They should only focus on helping new contributor. They are not supposed to translate a new string, because if that takes their focus away, then the new person might again feel lost and may not show up again. So then we set up a team, and then each team, the senior person helped the new people, gave a in-person walkthrough about the WordPress interface. So they no need to go through the entire documentation, which is nice, by the way, but this kind of gave them getting started with WordPress in 10 minutes. So after this teamwork, we spent 2 hours, and we achieved this first goal for the audience. The idea is to give back first. So the people who came that day to contribute something got a polyglot badge instantly, because there were GTEs who can check those strings in real time. Then we managed to finish Hindi-Marathi translation completely in the meetup, WordPress 4.6 core as well as videos. For Gujarati language, we only managed to achieve 70% because it was only at 60%. And somebody who worked on translations know that the earlier progress is made bit faster because people pick the smaller strings, something like save, publish, those kind of strings. And the last 10% strings are the big one. But after the meetup, there was 3-day weekend in India. Like for me, it was success. Like this meetup was success at this point only. But those people, they didn't sleep. For next 3 days, especially the Gujarati team, they were like, we also want to go get to 100%. Why should we be left behind? For 3 days and nights, they constantly worked on Slack, collaborated among themselves. Almost 90% of these people were first-time contributor. And then these people made it to the 100%. And I think WordPress 4.6 was first released with 50 languages. And the 50th language was Gujarati. And it was added to WordPress core just 5 days before. Like it was started translation 5 days before. It made to the core just 2 days before its release, the complete translation. So that's the effect of organized effort translation sprints can bring to your meetup. Thank you.